Welcome back to NewsPlus. I'm Mark Seagraves, and now my conversation with the longest serving member of Congress who's never voted. She's the delegate for Washington, D.C., Eleanor Holmes Norton. So we're into the 114th Congress, and I know there are a couple of things brewing. Locally here, I think a lot of people are obviously interested in gun laws. We know they are in Virginia and Maryland, and D.C. has some unique issues when it comes to gun laws. And obviously, we know in D.C. that Congress, or some members of Congress, like to tinker in those. We just had the case where the court said we have to issue, or at least make available, that it's not must issue, but shall issue carry permits, concealed carry permits, and only a couple have been issued thus far. Are gun laws for the District of Columbia at risk in the 114th Congress?
I hate to say it, but absolutely. There was an amendment that passed this Congress that would have eliminated most of our gun laws. I was able to get it off because we had a Democratic Senate. Now remember, there are Democrats in the House and the Senate who are gun people. Indeed, we passed the D.C. House Voting Rights Act. You may remember that was the bill that would have given us at least a House vote. That passed the House and the Senate, and the only reason that the delegate for the District of Columbia doesn't have a vote now is because the NRA attached this rider to the bill, and some of the Democrats voted for the rider. So if you could get it passed in the House and now you control the Senate, that is one of the things I'm on close watch for.
What do district residents need to watch for, or what can they do? Is there anything they can
do? Not a darn thing. We do need district residents, when things like this look like they're going to happen, to show up. Usually those rallies are organized by D.C. vote. We do need to show up. We don't need to just, I'm not saying that when you show up, the things are going to change. But if you don't show up, that sends its own message.
You know, there is other legislation that you're working on. You were very busy in the 113th Congress. One piece of legislation that you're working on, and this is something that as a general assignment reporter, I know we've reported on in the news several times over the past couple of years, seems to be getting more and more prevalent. And this is the issue of sexual assaults on airlines. And it sounds kind of bizarre to think that somebody would be sexually assaulted while they're taking an airplane ride. But that's exactly what's happening. People are being groped. People are being drugged in some cases. They're dropping things into their drinks, and then they pass out, and only to wake up and find out that they have somehow been assaulted. That you have actually are working on legislation in that area.
With a Republican co-sponsor, this is a bill that I think I can actually get through next time because I found that when I was introducing it, the way that there was a Republican introducing a similar bill, so we just got together. You know, you're right about being bizarre. It was not until I went with a number of members on a congressional delegation to London that I understood how this could possibly happen, and they're happening increasingly. You go on one of those trips, and one of the things you do is say, bring me a blanket. And it gets dark, and you lie there hoping you can get some sleep. I believe that most of this groping and the rest occurs then, because the women who have experienced this were sometimes even reluctant to speak up. They didn't want to scream out. I'm sure they tried to get this off of them, but it puts a woman in an untenable position. So when they get off the plane, they report it. And yet, although it is technically against the law, you can't prove it because the airlines don't have a way for you to report it. And until we have a system for reporting it, women who experience this groping or assault on an airline will have to wait until they get off, in which case most of them apparently feel they can't, they they cannot report.
And is anybody tracking these incidents, or is the None. FAA or local police? There's no tracking of
and
this.
And that is what my bill is about. And I've got a Republican male and me sponsoring it in the House. And you know, the House is not allowed to bipartisan bills being sponsored. So I think I'm going to actually get this one through.
Congresswoman Norton, we always enjoy it when you come by. Stop by anytime.
Thank you. I'll take you up on that.
Stay right there. When News Plus returns, we're going to be talking with the top cop in D.C.